Return to me, says the Lord of hosts, and I will return to you, says the Lord of hosts. Do not be like your fathers to whom the former prophets cried out. Thus says the Lord of hosts, return from your evil ways and from your evil deeds. But they did not hear or pay attention to me, declares the Lord. Your fathers, where are they? And the prophets, do they live forever? But my words and my statutes, which I commanded my servants the prophets, did they not overtake your fathers? So they repented and said, as the Lord of hosts purposed to deal with us for our ways and deeds, so has he dealt with us. On the 24th day of the 11th month, which is the month of Shabbat, in the second year of Darius, the word of the Lord came to the prophet Zechariah, son of Berechiah, son of Iddo, saying, I saw in the night, and behold, a man riding on a red horse. He was standing among the myrtle trees in the glen, and behind him were red, sorrel, and white horses. Then I said, what are these, my lord? The angel who talked with me said to me, I will show you what they are. So the man who was standing among the myrtle trees answered, these are they whom the Lord has sent to patrol the earth. And they answered the angel of the Lord who was standing among the myrtle trees and said, we have patrolled the earth, and behold, all the earth remains at rest. Then the angel of the Lord said, O Lord of hosts, how long will you have no mercy on Jerusalem and the cities of Judah, against which you have been angry these 70 years? Says the Lord of hosts, if you will walk in my ways and keep my charge, then you shall rule my house and have charge of my courts, and I will give you the right of access among those who are standing here. Hear now, O Joshua the high priest, you and your friend who sit before you, for they are men who are a sign. Behold, I will bring my servant through the branch, for behold, on the stone that I have set before Joshua, on a single stone with seven eyes, I will engrave its inscription, declares the Lord of hosts, and I will remove the iniquity of this land in a single day. In that day, declares the Lord of hosts, every one of you will invite his neighbor to come under his vine and under his fig tree. And the angel who talked with me came again and woke me, like a man who was awakened out of his sleep. And he said to me, what do you see? I said, I see and behold a lampstand all of gold with a bowl on the top of it, and seven lamps on it with seven lips on each of the lamps that are on the top of it. And there are two olive trees by it, one on the right of the bowl and the other on its left. And I said to the angel who talked with me, what are these, my lord? Then the angel who talked with me answered and said to me, do you not know what these are? I said, no, my lord. Then he said to me, this is the word of the Lord to Zerubbabel, not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord of hosts. Who are you, O great mount? Before Zerubbabel you shall become a plain. And he shall bring forward the top stone amid shouts of grace, grace to it. Then the word of the Lord came to me, saying, the hands of Zerubbabel have laid the foundation of this house. His hands shall also complete it. Then you will know that the Lord of hosts has sent me to you. For whoever has despised the day of small things shall rejoice, and shall see the plumb line in the hand of Zerubbabel. These seven are the eyes of the Lord, which range through the whole earth. Then I said to him, what are these two olive trees on the right and the left of the lampstand? And a second time I answered and said to him, what are these two branches of the olive trees which are beside the two golden pipes from which the golden oil is poured out? He said to me, do you not know what these are? I said, no, my lord. Then he said, these are the two anointed ones who stand by the Lord of the whole earth. Again I lifted my eyes and saw, and behold, a flying scroll. And he said to me, what do you see? I answered, I see a flying scroll. Its length is 20 cubits, and its width 10 cubits. Then he said to me, This is the curse that goes out over the face of the whole land. For everyone who steals shall be cleaned out according to what is on one side, and everyone who swears falsely shall be cleaned out according to what is on the other side. I will send it out, declares the Lord of hosts, and it shall enter the house of the thief and the house of him who swears falsely by my name. And it shall remain in his house and consume it, both timber and stones. Declares the Lord, two-thirds shall be cut off and perish, and one-third shall be left alive. And I will put this third into the fire, and refine them as one refines silver, and test them as gold is tested. They will call upon my name, and I will answer them. I will say, They are my people. And they will say, The Lord is my God. Behold, the day is coming for the Lord, when the spoil taken from you will be divided in your midst. For I will gather all the nations against Jerusalem to battle, and the city shall be taken, and the houses plundered, and the women raped. Half of the city shall go out into exile, but the rest of the people shall not be cut off from the city. Then the Lord will go out and fight against those nations as when he fights on a day of battle. On that day his feet shall stand on the Mount of Olives that lies before Jerusalem on the east, and the Mount of Olives shall be split in two from east to west by a very wide valley, so that one half of the mount shall move northward and the other half southward. Then the Lord my God will come, and all the holy ones with you. On that day there shall be no light, cold, or frost. There shall be a unique day which is known to the Lord neither day nor night, but at evening time there shall be light. On that day living waters shall flow out from Jerusalem, half of them to the eastern sea, and half of them to the western sea. It shall continue in summer and in winter, and the Lord will be king over all the earth. On that day the Lord will be one, and his name one. The whole land shall be turned into a plain from Geba to Rimmon, south of Jerusalem. One third shall be left alive, and I will put this third into the fire, and refine them as one refines silver, and test them as gold is tested. They will call upon my name, and I will answer them. I will say, They are my people. And they will say, The Lord is my God.
God wants a true people, a faithful people, a people who return unto Him, a people who will be repentant, and a people who will be faithful unto Him. Oh, the world winks its eye after you, and you go panting after the world. Don't you know that's nothing but the devil seducing you to lose your own soul, enticing you away from God? Huh? Come on, sober up. It's time to repent. It's time to return to God. And it's time to keep our covenants with God, to walk uprightly, and to serve Him with all that's within us. Because we only have one life, one chance upon this earth to live. And when it's over, it's over. And what you've done and what you've not done will stand there when you stand before God. And if you played with the world, if you committed spiritual whoredom, if you thought you could do it your way and somehow get by in it all, honey, you deceived yourself. And you'll find when you're sent to hell that you should have listened, that you should have walked uprightly with God, that you should have repented and returned unto the living God. Now I'm going to pray the salvation prayer. If you are far from God, pray that prayer. Return to God this day and turn from sin, turn from the darkness, and give it all over unto Him in repentance revolution. And repent of those things you do that are wrong and quit doing them. Quit doing them. Dear Jesus, we come to You this day in confession that yes, indeed, we have sinned, we have failed You, we have walked afar off. God, we confess that we've played the whore, that we've committed adultery in the spirit, that we've been a false swearer, that we've been a sorcerer, that we've been drunkards, that we've been drunk on the world and the riches of the world, that we've been choosing a way that You never ordained for us, that we thought we could have our idols and have You. And Lord God, we're wrong. We're wrong. And we repent this day. And we pray, Jesus, that You would enter into us and be our Lord, be our Savior, be our Redeemer. And guide us in the way that is life. Guide us in the way that is truth. And give us tender mercy. Because it is You that we want to please, Jesus. It is You that we want to serve. It is You that we want to obey. Because You are the Almighty God. And You are the one that is calling to all men throughout the earth to repent, to turn unto You, to come into Your truth, to come into Your light, to come into Your mercy. And it's You that we honor and praise this day. It's You that we desire to please. And it's You that we give thanks and praise unto. Amen.
Sin is not just what we have done, but what we have not done. As long as you are alive, probably still have a chance to repent. So don't put off repentance, or you'll end up in hell. If you're a sinner, you can't get in without Him. And if you're a church person, naming the name of Christ won't get you in either. If you don't obey Him, if you don't repent of your sins, whether you remain a godless sinner, name His name, you'll go to a place like this, hell. Hell is real, and you better not go there. But the righteous will go to life eternal. The repentant, those who give up their sins, who give their life to Jesus, who forsake all and follow Him, they will live with Him forever in heaven. And it'll be the most beautiful place you've ever been. And you'll be set free from sin. And it'll all have been worth it. And it is all worth it. Even now.